Hey guys, this is Srini, and in this video, let's discuss the best way to evaluate semantic segmentation. And obviously, we're going to use intersection over union approach. Now, I hope you know what semantic segmentation is. If not, you are wasting watching this video. Now, just a quick reminder, semantic segmentation, by that we refer to classifying individual pixel rather than classifying an image as a cat or a dog. But in this case, we are classifying individual pixels that belong to a cat or a dog. In this example, I'm just showing you a rock sample showing different minerals in the rock. But this is what semantic segmentation is. Now, what's wrong with accuracy, right? I mean, we do scikit-learn.metrics, and from metrics we normally import our accuracy that actually looks at our prediction and our ground truth and then gives us the accuracy. But the problem is it's not a great metric if you have class imbalance, which happens when you have multi-class problems in real life. So inaccuracy in minority classes, okay? If you have these minority classes, any inaccuracy there, they're completely overshadowed by the accuracy of the majority classes. For example, in this image, look at this. If you look at this image, all you see is blue and red. These are majority classes. So if I get 99.9% accuracy on these two classes, and if I get 50%, 40% accuracy on these minor classes, overall, the accuracy may be 95%, but that doesn't necessarily mean we are getting good accuracy from these minority classes. Hopefully that makes sense. Yeah. Now let's look at what IoU is and how it can help. Again, I apologize for this slide because it's got too much text. At least I get bored when I see these. So let me quickly go through this. IoU, by definition, is intersection over union. Intersection is basically overlap between your prediction and ground truth, right? And union is union between your predicted and ground truth. Now, if you want a Keras definition, it's basically true positives, okay? Which is a class that's labeled, you know, as, for example, 2, and how many of those are you getting it correctly, okay? So true positives are a class that's labeled cat. How many of cats are you correctly labeling as cats? Divided by true positive plus false positives, okay? Plus false negatives. How many dogs are cats and how many cats are misclassified as dogs, right? So when you add all of that, it's union. So that's the Keras's definition. Now, it's customary to report like a mean IoU or an average IoU. In fact, when you use the Keras's built-in function, it does report the mean IoU, but it's very important to look at individual class IoUs because it does tell you something about the accuracy of that class. And I'll show you how to do that using a confusion matrix. And don't be confused, it will be a very quick tutorial. Now, for this, I'm going to use the code that we have already used in my video 159B, where I talked about using pre-trained convolutional networks, specifically VGG16, I believe, not VGG19, but yeah, VGG16. And taking VGG16 and taking only the pre-trained weights and using that as feature extractor, sending our images and images through it, extracting the features, and then using a random forest to classify it. Please watch that video if you don't know what I'm talking about. And I'm not going to go through this code again. Only the part I'll go through is the IoU part. Now, what is our problem in this case? So here I have, let's delete this segmented. I was testing the code. Let's just keep our test1.image right there. This is the image that's actually, we are trying to segment. And the ground truth for this image is right here. Okay, so this is the image we are trying to segment. This is our test image, by the way, and this is the ground truth. So I'll train a model and use that model to segment the image on the right, and then take that segmented result and compare it against the ground truth using our IoU. That's the plan for now, okay? And all the testing, I'll just show you. I have training images, a couple of training images, and a couple of training masks, okay? And the masks, not many labels, very few labels for the mask. If you wanna draw your own masks for semantic segmentation, if you don't have a existing tool, you can go to www.appear.com, A-P-E-E-R. It's free. So sign up, go ahead and do this. That's how I do it. I did this, this specific example here. Okay, so now that you have good backstory, the whole part here is just reading the training images, reading the training masks, getting the data ready, and getting the VGG model, only the weights that got trained on ImageNet, and using that as feature generator, okay? And down here, when we come down, I'm going to, let's get down further. So I think I got way too further down. So let me go back one step. Yeah, there you go. I was looking for this random forest classifier. So we are basically classifying the features that got extracted out of, out of these images and then fitting a random forest. Again, please watch 159B. I sincerely apologize for speeding this through. This is not my teaching style, but I really want to focus on the main content of this video, which is why you probably tuned in. Anyway, so the assumption is, after all of this, you have a training image and a model, okay? Or a testing image and a model. So now, I already ran these lines, so I don't waste your time. So let's directly get down to the part where it makes sense, okay? So what makes sense now? I have model, I trained model. In fact, I saved that model. I'm loading that model, okay? Now, I want to test the accuracy. First thing first, let's go ahead and read the test image. If you remember the image I just showed you, resize it, obviously, all pre-processing, converting RGB to BGR, because that's what I did for my input images, and then expanding the dimensions to make sure the inputs to my prediction, to my random forest, are compliant. But before sending it to random forest, first of all, I need to predict it to extract features. Yeah, new model.predict. This is basically extracting features, and I'm reshaping it, and I'm performing my final prediction using random forest. What is the loaded model? The loaded model is the one that we trained on. Now, I'm just talking about the way I did segmentation. You probably have done your segmentation using OTSU. Very simple binary segmentation using deep learning, fully convolutional, or full, you know, any other approach, UNet, for example. It doesn't matter. Get to this point where you have a segmented image and your ground truth, okay? And I'm just showing you the way I got there. That's pretty much it, okay? And then I saved the image. Now that I have my segmented image, in fact, I may not have done this step. So let's go ahead and do this. In fact, I did that, but I deleted the file in front of your eyes. So let's go. Yeah, there you go. So I have my tested one segmented image. This is my segmented image. And if you remember this other image, test mask versus this. This is our segmented image. And this is our ground truth. Obviously, the ground truth is very clean. And the segmented image is kind of crappy in here. But let's see if we can mathematically extract, or extract some quantification, some values to prove that. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to also load my ground truth image because we are going to compare that in a second. And normally what would we do? We just do accuracy, right? You just say, okay, from scikit-learn import metrics, and from there accuracy score, go ahead and predict it. I'm curious. Okay, you're getting 94%. We're done, right? So normally 94% is pretty good. Maybe you increase the number of trees here from 30 to 40 and then see if it affects your accuracy, which it does. But let's not do that. That's not the goal. Finally, after 8 minutes or so, or 9 minutes, we are down to talking about IoU. Okay, so I'm going to use IoU. Again, you can write your own code because you know what I'm talking about, right? You can use logical AND and logical OR from NumPy to see if you can do intersection over union, or you can just create your confusion matrix and then get these things. But anyway, I'll just show you the Keras approach. So from Keras.metrics, import mean IoU. Okay, so this is what we are going to import right there. And then number of classes is 5, 0 being our background class. I don't think I have any pixels with a value of 0 in my image, but that's fine. Let's include that. And the way you instantiate your mean IoU is basically mean IoU and how many classes. Let's go ahead and put 5 classes in there. Okay, so that's how you started, and now we need to update it. Update it with what? With the truth and prediction, right? So our ground truth versus what we predicted. So let's go ahead and do that, and that should give you a tensor. You see here? So this is all my pixel value zeros. Obviously, I have no pixels with zero, so I'm not getting anything here. The next one is a pixel value of 1, and the next one is a pixel value of 2, the next one pixel value of 3, and pixel value of 4. Yeah, I have 4 pixel values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 0 being the background. So as you can see, majority of these are classified as correctly classified. I see wrong classification there, wrong classification here, but let's quantify. Why speculate, okay? So the best way, first of all, if you want to get a mean value for IoU, let's go ahead and select mean IoU. And the way you get that is, once you have your IoU.keras updated with this, you can just do dot result. Then it will give you your mean IoU. So let's print it out, and it gives us 77.9%. Already you can see a big difference. When you do accuracy, it's telling you 94%. When you do mean IoU, it's saying 77.9. That should tell you something is wrong, okay? Or, I mean, the accuracy is not as high. But if you just look at accuracy, you would be happy with 94%. This is exactly the reason why IoU can be very, very useful. Now, if you're curious about which classes are doing good, which classes are doing bad, now let's actually get down to now that we have this, right, we have this matrix, all we got to do is take your true positive, right, your true positive divided by true positive plus false positives, okay, and false negatives. So I just wrote these lines of code that actually does exactly that. I think I did a good, you know, did it the right way, but if any of you find anything wrong with this, let me know. But first thing first, I'm converting this tensor into a NumPy array, so let's go ahead and convert that. And now you can just print the values, so you can just see the values here. Well, let's actually go ahead and open up values. So I don't like this 10 to the power of 5. I'm not good at that. But anyway, you can see how my class number 1, okay? Most of these are correctly classified as class 1. Class 2, 39,923, and misclassified 7,000 there and 32,000. So this is pretty bad. Visually, you can tell that class 2 is not doing a good job because nearly half of the pixels that are supposed to be class 2 are misclassified as class 3. My class 3 is doing pretty good, 422,000 pixels. You see how the majority classes are doing pretty good, even though 3,000, some of these are off, that's fine. And class 4 is also doing pretty good, 25,000. And the reason why class 4 is doing good, even though it's minority classes, this is very bright pixels. It's easy to segment it. So it's doing good. This class, which is class 1 or 2, one of these majority classes, is also doing good because it's majority. The black region is also doing good. The class number 2, which is these gray, is not doing good because it's tough to segment those in reality. So visually, we have an idea. And now all I'm doing is exactly doing this, true positive divided by true positive plus false positives and all that. So let's go ahead and run these lines. And oh, I forgot to include print statements, which is not good. Let's go ahead and open it up here. Okay, so class 1. IoU is 0.963, 96.3% for class 1. Great. Class 2, 46.4%. Very horrible accuracy, as you can tell, right? And class 3 is 89%, not bad. And class 4 is actually 77.9%. So this bright phase is class 4. It's only 77.9. This dark phase, which is 44%. And these two are in about 90 or 90 plus percent right there. So what's wrong with this? Well, my class 2, I have to do something about it. What do I do in this case? I label more images, with class 2 being represented more. Okay, you can do some sort of balancing. You know, you can kind of increase the number of class 2s by following one of the methods I talked about, like SMOTE, S-M-O-T-E, or one of these, but you do that as a last resort. If this is the case in reality, 46% of accuracy, but others are doing good, This is a classic imbalance problem. So get 10 more images, but only label the ones that you want and increase the number of pixels that represent that specific class. But if you cannot do any of that, then think about balancing the data by either undersampling the majority class or oversampling the minority class. I hope you guys found this tutorial to be useful. And again, in the next video, let's cover something different, something useful, something fun. Thank you very much. And please do subscribe to my channel. Thanks.